Good morning, everyone. I'm Sonia Canevarolo. I have a degree in science for the conservation and restoration of cultural heritage, and I'm currently the R&D manager of FIRTEC, a startup involved in the study of new technologies for fire prevention of cultural site. The topic of this lecture concerns, therefore, the fire risk for cultural heritage, a subject that is unfortunately sometimes overlooked. Fire can have a devastating effect on historical structures, works of art, and ancient artifacts, causing irreparable damage to our cultural heritage. The magnitude of fire impact on historical and cultural building is little perceived, but it dramatically emerges when observing the number of lost work throughout the century, as we can see from some recent examples reported here. To fully understand this risk and how to mitigate it is essential to examine the causes of fire and the proper prevention practices. The most recurring factor that contribute to the high vulnerability of cultural and historical site to fire involved several aspects, including high fire load due to the presence of wooden structure, as well as flammable materials, the lack of adequate fire compartmentation, insufficient passive and active protection, as well as inadequate safety management procedure and inadequate training of personnel in fire safety and emergency management. Understanding the potential causes of fire can help any site manager to improve prevention measures. There are several factors that can give rise to fire, like extreme natural events such as lightning, earthquakes, or the spread of other fires, and numerous human-related activities. For example, negligence and poor maintenance of facilities, faulty wiring, intentional act of vandalism, war, terrorism, as well as unsustainable tourism and unsafe practices. In addition, the risk can significantly increase during renovation and building repair operation, which involve so-called hot works. In these cases, the risk is very high because new ignition sources may be present, such as temporary electrical installation, as well as more flammable materials than tools normally present. In these cases, a comprehensive fire safety plan specifically adapted to the additional risk during renovation or construction work is certainly necessary. Similarly, even minor maintenance carried out by internal personnel can be very risky and require special care. Regarding the causes of fire in cultural heritage site, research published in 2021 analyzes worldwide fire found in cultural heritage building from 1990 to 2019, which illustrate five main causes. Of these, the most common is vandalism, which accounts for 26%, followed by fire that occur during restoration, as well as electrical problems and short circuits and various kind of accident. Among all these causes, in recent year, the effect of climate change, which creates even increasing risk and extreme event, should certainly be highlighted. The consequence of a fire can vary significantly depending on factors such as the origin of the event, its spread, the ignition time, and total response time, including detection and extinguishment. In the spread of fire in a building, it is important to consider also the speed at which material can burn and reach the flashover stage. Structure and object, for example, made of plaster, gypsum, ceramic, brick and stone, have low heat sensitivity and combustibility, while other, composed of nitrocellulose or flammable solvent, have high sensitivity. Fire can have irreversible consequences and create irreversible losses, and therefore have enormous consequence. A collection can be completely or partially burned, and smoke, as well as soot deposit, can directly damage a building and its contents, leading to the loss of information about a collection if documentation is burned or if labels are destroyed, misplaced, or lost. Moreover, the high temperature reached during a fire can cause the melting, deformation, or discoloration of some artifacts. The physical forces that accompany a fire can cause also the fall of object or structural damage, eventually leading to the collapse of a certain part of the building. In addition to thermal damage, soot and other particulates deposited by smoke can also have harmful effects and the removal often require abrasive action, further damaging the material. Soot is often imperceptible and can remain on an artifact, and in the presence of moisture, it can promote the growth of mold and bacteria that quickly damage the artwork. The fire byproduct created by the thermal decomposition of material include smoke and toxic compound. This byproduct can cause damage such as corrosion, electrical malfunction, and discoloration, depending also on the type of fuel involved. Moreover, the loss of cultural heritage is often not only the direct effect of fire damage, but can also be attributed to indirect consequences. For example, water damage resulting from firefighting intervention or the use of other extinguishing systems can lead to high humidity, mold, and corrosion. Among the fire examples initially reported, water damage represented a significant part of the total loss of the Duchess Amelia Library Heritage, which was affected by a fire in 2004 caused by an electrical malfunction. In a landscape of so many factors that can influence the development of a fire with devastating effect, risk assessment can help establish priorities for the optimal preservation of a collection by implementing measures to prevent a fire, reduce its consequence, and prepare for a timely response in the event of such an incident. The process to reduce the risk of fire is similar to many common planning processes in heritage management. It may vary depending on the size of the site, but usually include the following steps: documenting significant site characteristics, defining specific protection objectives, identifying fire risk, and examining and selective protection solution. Fire protection practice involve various strategies to ensure the safety of cultural heritage. Fire protection can be divided into passive and active action, in which passive action include design and construction measures that make building and cultural heritage more fire resistant. These can involve the use of fire-resistant materials, the creation of fire-resistant compartments, and the design of escape route. While active action encompass the use of technological system and human intervention for fire detection and suppression. This system can be automated or require direct action from personnel to prevent or address a fire. Active and passive protection action should be integrated to create a comprehensive and effective system of fire prevention and control. In general, there are three main firefighting strategies which together contribute to the adequate protection of cultural sites. So, prevention, that aim to reduce the fire risk through measures and procedure to prevent fire from occurring. These may include the adaptation of fire-resistant materials, installation of safe electrical system, control of access to sensitive areas, firefighting safety training for personnel, and implementation of regular maintenance plans. Then detection, these refer to the installation of fire detection system, such as smoke, heat, or flame detectors. And this system can promptly identify the onset of a fire and activate alarm, allowing a rapid response to prevent the fire spread. Finally, suppression that involved measures taken to extinguish or contain a fire once it has been detected. This measure may include the use of portable fire extinguisher, sprinkler system, hydrants, or other automatic or manual fire suppression system. In conclusion, as we have seen, it is important to be able to identify the possible factor that can trigger a fire, considering the uniqueness of the site and the asset it contains. The combination of prevention, detection, and suppression strategies, together with disaster risk management and emergency preparedness, is essential. I would therefore conclude this first part of the lecture by emphasizing how crucial it is to invest in prevention, detection, and suppression measures, as well as in staff training to protect cultural heritage from one of the greatest threats it faces.